buddy joined your channel.
So please be honest about it. We're not going to be able to track down your lives. Once you lose them, please leave. And yeah, we should all have fun.
Buddy left your channel.
And if you have any questions, post them now.
No, but thank you very much again, ALPENWOLF, for organizing this.
You're welcome, buddy. 104th, of course, always the hosts. So that's great, too.
And of course, thanks to them.
We couldn't do it without you, buddy. Just to make sure that everybody understands how the lives work, yeah? And everyone understands how many lives you've got per aircraft you're flying.
For the Lima, 3 lives.
Yes.
And again, I think there's one Mistral is having 2 pilots, is that correct?
There's one Gazelle L Lima having 2 pilots.
Oh dear.
Okay,
me, Pitbull, Vicious, and Buntsman.
Okay,
I have a question about the response in the FARP. The FARP are setting with the corresponding park for each helicopter, because we have the risk to respond one over the other.
Just
so in that case, we're going to lose a life.
Well, I mean, this is done actually automatically by the mission editor. Every time in the mission editor you place a helicopter on the helipad, it's going to be right in the middle. You can't really assign helipads for each and every helicopter unless
next time just place them as takeoff from ground next to the FARP, and then they can take off, land on the FARP and rearm.
Alright, good point. So MI8 pilots, if you make it back and you want to collect troops once more, just don't land exactly on the FARP, just right next to it in case there's a K-50 or MI8 spawning. Same thing with the UH-1s.
Maybe a stupid question, but the troop pickup works with a CTLD script like on the server?
Yes. Siri Bob's script.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. So, Kami, there you are, buddy.
Why am I here?
Oh, I'm doing DCI.
Are you flying in the event?
I don't know. I can do Huey or I can do GCI.
If you want to take part, dude, you need to attend the brief. There's no real fucking mystery there.
Yeah. But I don't know what you want me to do. I just got a message from Bill saying they needed me. So, do you want me doing GCI or do you want me doing helicopter?
Well, you send me a message here, man, on TeamSpeak, telling me if we need GCI, then you can do it. You were volunteering, so what's wrong with you?
Well, you said that Tiger was doing it. I asked Tiger, and Tiger said he was doing it, so I left.
Well, Tiger said he would do it if no one would sue him. Just do it.
Jesus Christ, you guys are so confused.
Come on, he's got your beard or something.
This is fun.
At least we have on.
Very high morale, obviously.
Fucking gonna kill that bastard. Come on, let's beat the red team.
Always bleeding out of your vagina, Kami. Use some tank.
Nah, I don't think they need to blow the GCI, huh?
Nah, Kami, seriously.
Who is fine was one?
Question for GCI things. Do I need to have Lot ATC or can I use combined arms because I don't have Lot
ATC? We're going to put combined arms for this one just because Alpen doesn't have Lot ATC ready. But this will be the last event that we have combined arms doing GCI, guys.
Roger that. Don't get comfortable. Got it.
All right, come in. Like, I'm not going to force you, buddy. If you're up to something else.
No. I came in to do that. That's what I asked if you needed me. And then I asked Tiger. He said he didn't have his thing set up, so he was going to do GCI.
I can fly, and then you can do the GCI with Fallen.
Whatever works, guys. I don't mind.
Right, so I'm going to put a test. I'm going to put the test server up, guys, as per usual. So the server will be up for like 10 minutes. Everybody, get in the server, join, rearm your aircraft. Most importantly, please test your feckin' radios. Every month we do these competitions, guys, and then at the end it goes. People at the end of the event says, "Oh, it was really confusing because no one was on the right frequency." Well, make sure your SRS works, guys, and that you can hear people. Okay, so we'll test it for 10 minutes, then we'll bring it back down and we'll get it started for the top of the hour.
Just one question, is the GCI frequency in the briefing, or?
It's like always, 124 for red and 251 for blue. Let's get on 124 for red, and then I'll give you further information.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
All right, I'm just launching the server up. I'll give you the password in a little minute, guys.
Maverick, you just said top of the hour, didn't you?
Yes, mate.
It's very Irish of you.
Is it not top of the morning?
Same. Top of the anything's Irish, right?
I just feel honored to be here with these fine gentlemen.
How dare you? There's no fine gentleman here, I'll tell you that shit.
Oh, I'm reserved. If you need me, I'm here.
Kami's a girl, you know that.
Just a really deep voice.
Hey, Haggis. Really. Welcome, guys. Welcome to the stream. Sorry, it's probably going to be about 15 minutes before I can show you anything, but just bear with me. If any of you guys are using like TackView to record your, like, so when you replay the track, unfortunately we won't be able to submit a track, guys, because our machine doesn't actually save the track. So if you do want a TackView sort of review after the event, you're going to have to do the replay from either your replay or someone else's replay in the mission.
Yeah,
sorry,
just a little question for me. For the SRS channels for Blue, what channel does Blue use?
251.
251.
Yep. Okay. Alright guys, the password's in the chat. If you look on the Arrivals Lounge chat, the password's in there. If you just want to join the server now, again to reiterate, the server will be up for about 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Make sure your aircraft works, your radio works and all that sort of stuff. And then in about 15 minutes time, we'll bring the server down and we'll restart it and we'll get the event started.
Copy. Should we go to the blue comms or respective comms?
Well, you might as well stay here and shout out if there's any problems. Can the GCI guys please only use the... Let me have a... What are they called in the thing? The JTAC slots. Do not use Game Master.
Roger that.
Yeah, sorry, Haggis. I thought I would kind of do the server sort of started and get sort of people in the stream for when the event starts, because a lot of people always miss the start of the event, and that's normally when all the coolest sort of takeoffs and all that sort of shit happens. So you guys are stuck with that cool little image until we're up and running.
So SRS automatically connects you to the server when you connect to
the
server?
Hencom, did you sign up?
No.
Alright, you gotta leave then, bro.
Okay.
I just exploded when I responded.
User disconnected from your channel.
Yes.
Me see, you're always exploding.
Don't push the button again.
How do you know you didn't sign up?
I feel that someone else respawned on the same slot.
No, I just spawned and exploded.
Ah.
I asked him and he said no. Maverick, how do you know the answer? How did you know he didn't sign up? I just asked him, bro. He said no.
Like, you know what? I'll just look at the names here real quick.
I've got the thing in front of me as well.
Oh, right, cool.
Maverick, I will change to Game Master to check for the spawn areas.
Roger, buddy.
Guys, sorry, what's the password for the server?
It's on the chat.
123321. It's in the chat.
Oh, sorry,
I forgot what the PTT button was in the Huey. Can anyone help me with that, quick?
You said that yourself.
Was it pilot's radio, trigger radio, right?
Oh, right. So on the left hand, in the center console, down in the bottom left, you'll see the rotary switch move all the way around to PVT.
Comm
check 251. So I just have FF copy.
Radio check, easy comm. Oh, Zach, that's a hard question to answer.
Blue guys, just a little heads up. If you're wanting GCI, I will be known as Commie1. Nice and easy. Also, if you're talking on 251, I will tell you to shut the fuck up, because we want nice clear comms, guys.
Come here, I will send you the link for the for the briefing.
I've got it, bud. You mean the Ed Forums link?
Guys, you can set your radios up any way you want, but the way we recommend it in the 104th is that you have one button to push to talk on SRS and a different button to push to talk on TeamSpeak, so that you can use TeamSpeak to speak to your wingmen and talk to other people that are in your flight, but you use SRS only to talk to the AWACS guy.
I see two slots open on the Huey still. Do you need the reserves at all?
Is Grim copy?
Come check 251.
Zach, I don't know, man. It's close between the Huey's great fun to fly. I mean, it doesn't. It's a transport helicopter. I mean, you can carry guns and stuff like that. I would, the Gazelle's probably the most fun because you can shoot down other jets. There's probably that's the most fun I think you can have in a helicopter in DCS is actually shooting down an enemy jet with a helicopter, and the Gazelle's great fun for that. So it really depends on what you want to do in the server when you're flying, but I'd say it's between the Huey and the Gazelle. They're both great fun. If you're just joining the stream, welcome guys. I know that you can't see anything. We are basically doing a quick test. We do a test for like 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Holy shit. There's a helicopter spawned inside a truck. Who is that?
Repeat, please.
He didn't spawn inside it. He flew to it and landed in it.
Oh. Missy, you maniac. Bro, you'll be looking at a ban. 9-year ban, Missy.
I see one Huey slot still open. Bullet spawn in that one. Or you give your list full.
Yeah, so what we're doing right now, guys, I'll show you, hold on. We're just sort of testing the. Everybody's testing their weapons, their radios, they're testing their aircraft, make sure they can take off and all that sort of stuff, all the radios work and shit. So, this is just something we do because we've learned from experience that if you don't do this, there's always something. Always something. So, for 10 or 15 minutes before the round starts, we always do like a quick test.
Yeah, also for the blue team, please, with the crews, check the troops. If you can pick up troops or deploy. Yeah, loading troops works. Copy that. Coming, check link that I sent you.
This is Bogan, Sanchez 124.
So looks like the red side are good.
I'm sorry, okay. Gotta ask again. What was the red GCI frequency? 124?
124.
Yes, 124.
And that's also the radio check frequency for the test run right now.
It's for the test run, yeah. When we go down the other team speed channel, only red, I will give you another frequency, you know, for the data and stuff, for the radio system. Whoa, what was that? Somebody's transmitting on 251 and I can hear him? How's that?
What slot are you in?
I'm GCI and I can listen. Probably a red guy. Maybe some red guy is transmitting on 251 and I just thought it was a blue guy.
Yeah, Secure Coalition Radios is on. I'm looking at it right now.
All right, cool.
And okay, spectator audio is disabled as well, so anybody that you hear is red.
Alright, guys, 1, 2, 4.
Copy, 1, 2, 4.
Alright, so there's no problems, guys. No one's identified any issues. We can basically get this started now. So what we're going to do is we're going to put all the blue guys in blue comm 1 channel. You're going to have a quick brief, and then we'll get the mission started. Same for red. Red, you can all join red comm 1 and do your little debrief and then get yourself separated out. as usual, guys, the channel passwords are the channel numbers. So 1 is 1, 2 is 2, 3 is 3, and all that sort of stuff. So if you, unless anybody has, if you have any questions, stay here. If you don't have any questions, move into your blue and red respective channels.
Okay. All blue team in channel one, please.
User
all
left right. Your channel. Buddy left your channel. User left your channel. User left your channel. Channel switched.
All right, I'm going to jump up here because we're just going to have like 60 seconds of user left your channel. User left your channel. So we're closing in, guys. We're about 10 minutes away from getting this shindig started. 5-10 minutes away. I'm also running a 60-second delay on the stream, guys, just so no one gets stream sniped during the event. So sorry if I miss any questions or shout-outs or anything like that, guys. I love you all. I'm not ignoring anyone. Alright, why are you guys still here?
User was moved out of your channel.
That's a fucking herd of cats, guys.
User was moved out of your channel. User
was joined out of your
channel.
Dodge, come on, buddy.
Yeah, I'm fucking... he's on blue. I'm just trying to work out which team they're on. That's him.
Alright, there we go.
But who, do we need anybody for... User
yeah, go ahead.
Do you need a red guy?
Where did he go?
Just Eons is in the reserve lounge.
Well, I'll just try him. Where's Mustang? Let me pull Mustang.
Ah, I don't know. He should be here. I don't know why he's not. Sorry.
All right.
User left your channel switched. Connected. Channel switched. Sound muted.
Ah, sweet Jesus. Right, what am I doing? Oh yeah, hosting this fucking event. Oh hey guys, I'm streaming. Hey guys, welcome. Alright, hold on. I promise you, this stream will go somewhere. Eventually. It's a beautiful journey, guys. We'll take it together. I clicked a hell of a day to stop taking methamphetamine. Oh, a little bit of Tom Cruise / Tomcat love. I think so, guys. I think so. It must be close. I'm getting a hard on. Right, so we're kind of sort of getting there. Off to a bit of a rough start, apparently. Yeah, I don't really know too much about the starting procedure, so I'm just going to let them get on with it, guys. I'm not going to jump in. Hey, you're not supposed to be starting your engines. I don't really know what's going on. I'm just here commentating, guys. Welcome on board. It's your host with the most, with a burnt bit of toast. 104th Maverick, helicopters, round 4. Holy shit, son. How did we get here? So we've got a blue side spooling up. Hold on, I'm going to have to, hold on. And it's, and for the sake of partiality, I'm going to have to do something here, hold on.
Channel switch.
Alpen, they're starting their engines on the blue side, so you guys might as well spool, but stay on the ground.
Roger that.
Channel for the switch. Two corridors,
guys, make sure you stay on the ground until you're told that you can take off, okay?
Channel switched.
Right, we should be good. So yeah, welcome guys, welcome, welcome. We are round 4 in the helicopter PvP event. Got another good one set up here by ALPENWOLF. So we've got quite a good number of players today. We have a good contingent of K50s for the red side, getting backed up by the Stalin buses. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 Stalin buses that are going to be on patrol. We have a good number of Gazelle Ls. We have 5 of them, and we have 3 Gazelle Mistrals, which are the air-to-air Gazelles with the heat-seeking missiles. We have the Missy, from who's basically been in every single helicopter round so far, I think, flying the Huey with bullets, also 104 Cadet Bullet. We've got Grumpy Finn in the Huey. Kawa from OR in the Huey with Morning Mode, and DJ Switch as well following up. So got a good little contingent here. Good, I think it's going to be good. We have Commie doing the GCI for the fighter control, well not fighter control, helicopter control for the blue side, and ALPENWOLF doing it for the red side. Both sides do have AWACS. We have an E2 on station for the blue side and an A50 on station for red. These obviously won't be targeted. These are not valid targets. They're up at 14,000 feet doing like 300 odd knots. I think I'd be pretty impressed if a helicopter can actually reach up there and touch that. But basically what the objective is there's going to be the red side starting from here and the blue side starting from here. The blue side are trying to defend this area here with the FARPs where they can rearm and refuel, and red side similarly are trying to do the same thing on the eastern side of the mission here. So everybody on red side's getting fueled up and spooled up. Hopefully, yeah, we can hear engines and stuff. It's a busy old place. Some technical... Oh, no. Well, I don't know what's going on there. Some interesting... these might be like stealth K-50s or something. Like ground camouflage. Low, I think these are the low radar cross-section variants, that's what it is. Alright, I've just been told that I'm in charge of when the event starts, so that's good, so let's just crack on. Called 30 seconds just because we need to get the show on the road. We're 6 minutes behind schedule. I see some of the MI8s have not even got their engines spilled. I don't know if that's part of their plan. They'll all be scrambling for engine start switches now, I'll tell you that though. So we'll give them just over 30 seconds. I think the blue side are pretty much all ready to go. Who have we got on the end here? We've got Pitbull Vicious on the end and the L. So yeah, blue side looking good, ready to go. We'll take a little trip up the flight line here. So the Gazelle's rearing to go. Ten-4, good buddies. Right, we're getting a good spot to see the takeoffs. Alright guys, here we go. Bullets, first one up. Right, welcome guys, sorry if you're just joining us, this is a helicopter PvP event. Every aircraft you see here has been flown by a real person. Try and get some nice shots of the guys departing out here. This should be a good one here. Some bro with his light still on and his gear down. Love this guy. Oh, someone's crashed. Hashtag disaster. Oh dear. Alright, he'll trim that out. They'll work that out, guys. Both sides, they actually, there's a different number of lives. Every pilot, apart from the Mistral pilots, all have 3 lives. So you can basically get shot down twice and then get back in the fight, and then the third time you're out. But the Mistral pilots only have 2 lives, as far as I'm led to aware. As far as I'm led to be aware. I don't even know what I'm trying to say there. Sorry, guys. Again, if you're just joining us, I have a 60-second delay on the stream, so I apologise if I'm missing any... If you're saying hello, you're asking any questions, or you're... I've just noticed that Disney says hello there. Hey, buddy, sorry if I don't answer your questions, guys. I'm running a delay on the stream, and I've got to kind of make this my main focus as well. So I appreciate you being here. I'm sure these guys appreciate you showing up to watch the fight as well. So thank you very much, guys, and welcome. Hopefully this is going to be a good one. A good old bullet. No stranger to a bit of drama. He's looking at getting wheel and dealing in there. We've got Kayakawa in the back, Pitbull Vicious in the L. So this is the variant with the gun. So these guys are trying to get in there with the Gazelle. Try and rip some people up with a cannon. It's going to be awesome to watch, guys. We do have the deadly octopal fire on form as well. I think he is on the blue side, so that is bad news for Red. Good old Octo. I'm sure Octopal's in here. I think I seen his name earlier on. Is he flying? If he's not, that's a shame. I'm sure. Is he in? Yeah, he's in. So yeah, the red side are in big trouble. Octopal fire famously just absolutely, I mean, the guy deadlier than the plague in that thing in one of the rounds that we had previously. I think it was like 15 on 15 Octopal Fire managed to shoot down 780 enemy aircraft somehow. So we're going to see some good action here, guys. I mean, we're off to a bit of a slow start. Thanks for bearing with us. It's going to be a little bit. It's a little helicopters here, guys. We're not flying any fast movers, so it's going to take a little while to get everybody in position. But look at Red. They look awesome. You know, Musters representing the 104 fees ready to go. But yeah, we're going to see some good action here, guys. There's going to be some good kills, some good gunfights as well. There's going to be a lot of missiles fired, and there's going to be a lot of rounds expended. So we got Requiem, Iskrim, Yambo, Fox One, Mustang, Wyan, Aggressor, Treno, Eons, Fortinero, all heading out in a nice little sort of grouped package here that can support. We've got the Stalin buses in the back with Eons, I think was our bro. No, he's not got the landing gear down. He's a trained professional. He's kind of hanging back to make sure those guys are nice and safe. whereas on the blue side, we have good old Bullet, who's leading the charge here in a Huey, followed by Kayakawa, Morning Mode, Pitbull Vicious to the north, DJ Switch. We got Prophet, Grumpy Finn, Dutch, Missy, Dope Man, Varys as well. I think Octopal Fire has just departed with 104th Tiger in the rear. So more of an extended sort of train coming out on the blue side. Pitbull Vicious maybe looking like he's sort of slowing down, maybe looking for a bit of an ambush position, trying to get, yeah, that's exactly what the guy's doing. This is very sensible here. He's offsetting himself to, so that all the reds are going to come flying down his right hand side. If he's smart, he's going to just stay here, stay on this high ground and just be looking down into this valley down here that we can see on our right hand side, watching for the red guys getting some weapons employed. It looks like that is what he's going to do, so I like to see that. That's some good tactical decisions there. Bullet has offloaded some infantry, which is awesome. So it looks like we're securing Gadada. So yeah, these guys want to secure this airbase and make it as difficult as possible. So blue side not only looking to secure, so sorry, yeah, I got a little bit confused at the start. Blue side looking to secure Novo, as obviously, as well as defending their FARP area. The red side are looking to secure Galednik and their FARP, which is what is going on now. We have the MI8s coming in. Some fast fucking landings by the MI8s. There's no messing around by the Stalin buses today. Holy shit. There's another scoop and poop right there. Look at these guys. So both sides, boots on the ground here. We got another MI8 coming down. We'll see if we can get the camera down a little bit here. Those guys just getting thrown out the aircraft. That was a nice little touch and go by Fortinero. So the red side with their, the red side have their shit together today, guys. Nice. So now we have a nice little package of K-50s heading out. We have the Stalin buses heading out a little bit more feet wet. I'm not sure what the plan is for those guys. Wizard is creeping. He's the guy on the creep right now. It looks like these two are going to end up shackled up together at some point reasonably soon. They're separated by 5 miles at the moment, which... they definitely don't have line of sight on each other, but this could get tasty with those guys. This might be our first shot exchanged up here, guys. Wizard and Pitbull might be the first shots. Again, to reiterate, if you're just joining us, both sides have a human doing ground control. So they basically, to cut a long story short, they have someone on the radio telling them where the enemy is. Oh, look, a cup of coffee. Right, let's have a quick look on the blue side and catch up what the sitch is here. We've got the once Raven guys, the OR guys. Nice little formation arrival, formation departure. Love these guys. These guys are regulars in the 104th missions and events that we do. These guys always show up and put on a good show as well. Nice, nice capable guys. Switch on the down low. Touching down! Right, we're going to get some... Somebody's going to get killed soon. Somebody's going to get hurt, guys. We've got Pitbull. So hopefully Pitbull's been made aware from his GCI that there is an enemy helicopter just about coming over the ridge. She'll be coming over the mountain when she comes, Pitbull. Make sure you're ready. DW. I don't think their air traffic controller guy would see Pitbull. I don't think the red fighter controller will see him from their AVAX. Oh, here we go, guys. Here we go. Look at this. We got Yambo and Requiem just balls on the table, just running in there, guys. Here we got Prophet. I'm going to match them on the L. We got no shots fired just yet, but these guys are close AF. Oh shit, son. Yep. Yeah, that'll happen, bro. I'm not sure what happened. Yeah, he just killed it. That was a, unfortunately, that was just a maneuver. So I'll claim that one, guys. I'll claim the first kill. So here we go, K-50. He's got the gazelles pushing right in on me. Doesn't even see him. Yambo is making himself, he's putting himself in a really bad position. We got our first guns out, guys. Yambo's in big trouble. Prophet coming in with the guns. Yambo's going to turn in though. The problem is there's another gazelle right to the left hand side, so he's 2-on-1. He looks like he's actually turning cold. Maybe there's a dragon bag here. These guys are trying to get dragged out. Vicar inbound on Dutch. Oh, he's hit. He is hit. He's going to have some problems there. Stuff's coming off that aircraft. Yeah, we need that. Unfortunately, we need that main rotor, guys. Nice. That's a kill by Mustang. Deadly. Guys, absolutely deadly in this. We've seen Mustang get a lot of kills in the last round as well with the K50. So first kill on the board to 104th Mustang. Good job, dude. Good job. We have Yambo running away from Prophet, who's just about to go cold. We have Pitbull still sort of keyed up on Vicious. These guys don't... Sorry, Pitbull on Wizard. They're only separated by 1.8 miles, but they definitely don't see each other. Yambo and Mustang deciding to come cold. The Stalin Bus 2 ship from Fit... What? We're up at 4,000 feet. We're almost going to fly into each other. What the... What is going on here, guys? ECV 56 coming up with some sort of Batman tactics here. Multiple flares going out as well. What is this madness? Maybe they're trying to cause a distraction or something. Maybe they're trying to get everybody to look at them or something. It doesn't seem to be working. The blue side, rather than kind of bullishly heading out over the bay to chase these guys down, are all sort of staying close. Where are the Mistrals, though? Where did they go? Octopole looking to flank around on the north. Pitbull looks like he's maybe getting a bit impatient and is deciding to reset now. We have Tiger coming up in a Mistral. He's got to cross over this ridgeline before he can start shooting McTootin. So yeah, Mustang leading the charge for the red side. We have two Stalin buses just balls to the wall, just straight in there. We have the L of Prophet, who's probably definitely sees these guys, the Stalin buses. But yeah, they're flaring. Oh shit, we got rockets and everything. These guys are trying to take out the infantry. This is awesome. Look at this, guys. Holy shit. Look at all these rockets coming down. Oh, look at all this. Look at all this. Oh my god. Oh my god. Did they kill anything? That is fucking awesome. Another Vicar out by Musters. Looks like he's going to be tracking one of the Hueys. Kaya Kiowa looks like he's going to get it in the face. Oh, and he got a Mustang. Another kill to Mustang. Jesus Christ, Musters. Oh, not sure how accurate that is. So Mustang with another kill. It looks like we've got more rockets coming inbound now, guys. So the Stalin buses very sensibly deciding to come in with some rocket attacks to kill the enemy infantry that the blue helicopters are deploying. This is fucking genius. Now we have Switch, who's just been taken down. Switch trying to chase down the Stalin buses in a Huey, while Mustang is just raining fucking terror. Boom, there goes another one. God damn it, Mustang, where's the mercy? Switch is mixed up with K50. He's trying to get his door gunners to get some shots out. And the K50 is hit. And he's going down. He is going down, ladies and gentlemen. So that is a kill for Switch. Switch got a minigun kill on Yambo there. Good flying there, Switch. Unlucky for Yambo. But Mustang, Jesus Christ, just wheeling and dealing. We got Wizard and looks like Tiger's going to be getting a shot off on. Maybe Octopole Fire's going to come around him. Wizard's in big trouble here, guys. Wizard is in a lot of trouble. He's got Octopole Fire in the rear, and he's got Tiger in the front. Both pilots have GCI, so they have a rough idea where each other are. But if this guy's not careful, Octopole Fire's going to run up and shoot him in the face. Alright, doesn't look like Tiger's going to get eyes on him. Octopole Fire, I think, sees him. We're going to stay. Yeah, Octopole Fire sees him. He's off Octopole Fire's nose now. Octopole Fire only has guns, so he can't fire any missiles at this guy. Right, we're going to switch away from this just now. I'll come back to that as fast as I can, because it looks like it's going to get tasty there. Bullet looking like he wants some. He's running head on head. Bullet's in big trouble here. He's going head to head with Fox 1, but more importantly, Mustang is in the back. The deadliest of deadlies. Mustang will be queuing up Bullet right now. You'll be looking for him in the sensor. That's exactly what he's doing. Mustang's trying to get a shot. What's the word I'm looking for? A solution. That's what he's looking for. That's the word I'm looking for as well. So we're looking at Mustang going to be launching pretty soon on Bullet. He's going to ruin Bullet's day. It's a quick jump to F10 to see what's happening up the top here. Oh shit, Blizzard's going to chase down Telja. I don't think he sees him though. He's passing left to right. He doesn't see him. Fire controller will be screaming at Telja, bro, you're merged and he is behind you. Octable fire is maybe still tally visual. Telja doesn't look like he's doing a good enough job to turn around, so I don't think he sees him then. Mustang hasn't fired a bullet yet. Maybe he did. Bullet's dead. Must see it. Oh, fuck, we missed it, guys. Look, Monofourth Mustang takes down Bullet. We're going to have to take Mustang out. Jesus Christ, this guy, somebody nerf Mustang. He's 4-0 already, at least 4-0. Alright, Wizard's in big trouble. Wizard is in big trouble. Octable, here comes Octable Fire. Oh, dude. Oh, dude. And that is all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen. No mercy. K50 strong though is. Currently we have no fucks given. Oh, he's going down. He is going down. Into the trees. Down he goes. Octable Fire bringing the pain. Bringing the pain. Eon's kind of looking in there. He's going to get himself into big trouble if he just wanders in there on his own. Those guys will be able to respawn and come back though. They'll need to try and just keep the coordination up so that they're not all getting too segregated. This could get tasty. Eon's going to be in a spotty bother. He's got three gazelles off the nose. One of them is the Black Plague that is Octable Fire. Eons is going to pop right over this fucking ridge line and all hell is going to break loose. Oh, he's going to hit that tree. No, he's going to be okay. He's right behind Freedom. Look at this. Where's the AMRAM, bro? None of them see him. Not one of them see him. Come on, dude. Let's make this count. Come on, bro. Oh, they're getting calls now. They're definitely getting calls now. Yeah, it is too late. It's too late, bro. We are dead. Right, we'll stay with Octable. Octable's definitely targeted. Sees a K50 off the nose. Looks like he's deciding to go left, though, so he might not have Tally Vig. We have Telja, who looks like he's definitely... No, doesn't seem to see him either. A lot of guys struggling with the visibility to try and see these people. I'm not judging anyone. Here's my man Missy coming out here with Grumpy Finn. Looks like they're pushing the Reds back off the bay. We still have some blue infantry on the on the airfield, which is good. Eon's looking to flow west, maybe thinking more sensibly. Hey, listen, this is a bad idea. This was a good idea that got out of hand. And I'm getting the fuck out of here. I think that's what his program is right now. Octable Fire trying to chase him down. Telja and Tiger still turning, looking for him in the wrong place. They'll get the picture pretty soon enough and they'll start chasing out after him. But I think Eon is going to be get out of there. Missy turning cold. Grumpy Finn looking like he is also turning cold. Those guys thinking more sensibly. Hey, I don't really want to get mixed up by K50 and over the water. In fact, there's three K50s out there. Here comes Mustang. Just wishing a motherfucker would. Oh, we're wishing. Here we go. Oh, and he fucking hits him! Jesus Christ! Good God, Mustang! Jesus Christ, this fucking guy. Right, Reds seem to be deciding to flank along this ridgeline here. If we look at these guys, you see that there's a ridgeline on our left. So they kind of sensibly maybe want to just stay away from the water and try and act as a bit of an ambush coming round from where Eons is. Eons looking like he's flanking round to the west again, trying a similar sort of thing. Interestingly though, oh dear. Ah, you'll trim that out. We'll get somebody out there to fix that. That'll be fine. Seen better days though. Good old Tiger. He'll work that out, guys. He's a trained professional. He'll get that fixed. Eons might come and kill him though. I don't think Eons would, like, if he, I don't think he would get him on radar. Like, the radar controller won't be able to vector him on, but maybe Eons will actually fly over him, see him, and then kill him. Right, Mustang just creeping in again, just wishing. Just wishing. Someone would just show themselves. Identify yourself, he says. Oh, he sees Grumpy Finn off the nose here. This could be bad for Grumpy Finn. So Mustang just sweeping, he's looking for Grumpy Finn. Grumpy Finn is just very sensibly, he is hiding from Mustang right now. That is the best call anyone's made all day so far, because as soon as Mustang sees him, he puts him down straight away. A Vicar out from Eons on Telja. Come on, Eons. What you got, bro? You got it? Oh, he got him! What a shot! Look at that! There goes the tail roar. Goodbye, son. I'm afraid you need that. What a shot by Eons. Great job, sir. Absolutely great job. Octopal Fire getting the word on the street now. Hey bro, we got a K50 in the rear and he is taking down friendly. So he's recommitting round to the east. Going to be popping up on this side here. Great shot by Eons on the cold gazelle there. He's now head on, so he'll be looking for Octopal Fire. He's got some good altitude. There's Tiger down off the nose, which he doesn't see. Just Octopal down there low though, creeping. Don't think Octopal sees this guy. Telja might see him, he does see him. We got a fox out, guys. Missiles tracking. Octopal Fire's in big trouble here. Oh, it missed. Something came off the aircraft. I think he's in trouble. He's maneuvering hard. Oh shit, I think we got hit. What happened? There's bits falling off our aircraft. Maybe he's just, yeah, he is in big trouble, guys. Big trouble. I think he's just overstressed the aircraft and, yep, punching out. Let's find out. No one hit him, guys. He's just ejecting. Yep, he overstressed I think he had a rotor collision there. He too excited, trying too hard to get the nose down. I'm going to claim that as well, guys. That's two kills for me. Right, so Octopal Fire has it under control. He's got three K-50s coming up, though. They look like they're going to get... Oh shit, Muster's flying cold now because he's got all these angry village people coming running out with their pitchforks. Hey, you fucking bastard. Doesn't look like they see Fox 1 though. Fox 1 in a good position to do a lot of damage. Is he going to make it count? There he is there, the Huey does not see him, and looks like he's not even targeted on Dutch. Dutch doesn't see him either. Still got Tiger up there. I don't know why Tiger just doesn't take a new aircraft, dude. Just spawn again. It looks like Dutch is going to run down Fox 1. Does Dutch see him though? He has to see him, he's right off the nose. Yeah, he sees him, he's just not doing... Well, we're doing 130 knots, I was going to say he's not doing a good job at catching up, but he is flying at his fastest speed, so I can't give him too much shit. So hopefully maybe some gun rounds out here. Come on, buddy. Lead pursuit, bro. Lead pursuit. Let's go. Nose up. Come on, Dutch. Come on, brother. He sees you, bro. We need fire. Looks like Switch coming with some rounds and a Huey as well. Dutch, why are we not shooting, fam? I don't think he's got his master arm on. That's going to be a maneuver kill. Oh, here we go, finally, fucking hell. Let's go, bro. This guy's got so many rounds, just let them go, dude. Go, 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 shoot, shoot, shoot. Good shots, good shots. Switch trying to get some long range rounds in with a door gunner. Oh, there it is! There it is! hope you can swim, champ. This might be Karma coming. Oh my god, Karma! He's got freedom right in front of him! Come on, Octopal Fire's gonna kill all three of them here. Come on, dude, come on! Holy shit, he fucking missed! Oh, he got one! Oh, great ambush, dude. Great ambush by Octobal here. Although the tables are turning a little bit. Well, I did get one of them, although the game's up now. K50s know what's going on. One of them crashed as well, so we had three. He's down to two. It's now a one-on-one. Oh, he's going down! Finally, karma comes for him. Boom! Octopal fire, though, with a great job. Takes one guy. I think he got the kill on the second guy. Definitely, certainly a maneuver kill anyway, so great show again by Octopal. Vodka Lazy Seal coming in slowly here. So chaos, guys. Absolute chaos. How long have we got to go? God damn, I'm shattered already. We've only been fucking... This has only been going for 30 minutes. God damn. This K50 sees us, but we don't see this K50. This guy's in trouble. Dope, man. You need to get off the weed, bro, and start looking left. Come on, K50. Shoot! What the fuck? We're landing! What the fuck? Oh my god! He's in a Mistral as well, so that was an air-to-air shot. He's in big trouble. He needs to put some separation between him and this K50 so he can get a weapon off. This might be too close. This might be arm in. Oh, he gets him! Oh, dude. Oh, my God. It's still fucking flying. What the fuck? He's still back there, bro. Oh, no. Oh, I thought he was shooting Vickers at us. Come on, dope. Let's go, bro. Third time lucky. Third time lucky, champ. Surely that's it. Yes. Down he goes. God damn, what a fight. What a fight. Dope man on Y-N. Jesus Christ, that's one for the highlight reel, I tell you that. Alright, here we go. We got Yambo and Lazy Seal head on with DJ Switch. Oh, Switch is in deep shit. Come on, Lazy, let's go with the guns, bro. Here we go. Oh, he's hit, but he's still shooting. Get him, dude, get him, Switch, get him, bro. Oh, this will be awesome. Get him, dude, get him. Oh, he fucking got him, bro. He's on fire, he's still wheeling and dealing. I love this guy. Are we going down? Oh shit, someone's attacking Lazy as well. The cavalry's coming, guys. The once Raven cavalry has arrived. OR to the rescue. Oh my god, look at this! He's fucking- the gazelle can't even see him because of the water. Ah, oh, down he goes, down he goes. Good job, guys. That was awesome. That was fucking awesome. So Lazy Seal taking about 4,000 rounds to the back, to the ass there. Oh shit, here comes Wizards coming in for the rescue here. Morning Mode's in trouble. Oh, look. Oh yeah, he got him, he got him. We are going down, ladies and gentlemen. Super 6-1 is going down. That's a good kill by Wizard coming to the rescue there. So it's all kicking off now. The Stalin bus is trying to run down a gazelle. I don't know how good. I don't know if that's a great idea. Ah! Oh shit, son! Yep. Engine fire left. Engine fire left. Oh, and he takes them down, ladies and gentlemen. There's the money shot. Nice, nice fucking shot, dude. That is awesome. That's OR. Is that, I'm not sure which one that is. Sorry, that's Profit. That is Profit. Good job, Profit. Way to go, guys. Way to go. Some great flying this round, man. This has been a good one. This has been, I really enjoyed this. Holy shit, here comes the Red Army. The Blue need to start hustling, guys. Come on, Grumpy and Missy. We need you guys over here. We need the flying fins. God damn it, somebody get me the finish in here. Alright, Profit is in deep shit here. He made these Stalin buses guys are trying to kill the blue infantry on the ground here. Profit is trying to defend them. Oh, shot fired. Alright, looks like we're out of rockets. It's just Profit on his own here, and he is surrounded. We need Octable Fire. Someone put the call out. We need the finish in here. We need Octable Fire. Tiger, come on, guys. Everybody hustle. Get in here. Looks like Ollie is trying to get in there to drop off troops. This is not good for the red side, guys. For the blue side. Holy fuck. Oh my god. Some Mistral just came in from nowhere and fucked this guy up. Poor Baron is now... Baron's day went from bad to worse. That was Tiger in the Mistral. Good job, Tiger. Nice. Raxum and Shaxum. Good job, Tiger. Nice kill, buddy. Oh, he fired again. Christ, there's so many targets in front of him. This is unbelievable. Yambo just trying to get anything done. We've already lost the left wing on the K-50 there. The left pod's hanging off. So Yambo's definitely seen some better days. We've got gazelles, just all sorts of aerobatics off the left-hand side. All sorts of flight model nonsense going on here. This is awesome. So here's a Vicar coming in from Wizard. It looks like that's going to be a good shot. Takes out Grumpy Finn. Grumpy Finn goes down. From the, that looks like the shot, I don't know if that's a maneuver kill or if that's, Wizard's actually going to get the credit for that, so good job, Wizard. Yambo still alive, doing a great job. No one seems to be targeted on Wizard though. Missy and the Huey trying to kill these troops. So Missy gunning the MIA on the ground here, trying to kill the enemy infantry that debarked from the helicopter. These guys are now merged. Holy shit, there's so much happening, guys, sorry. We'll try and stick with this for a little second. So Kayakawa just trying to get nose on to Yambo, but Yambo's doing a good job of just staying above him. Yambo might be able to get some shots out here. Another Huey coming to try and help Kayakawa out. There's a Mistral coming in from, looks like Varus. Varus trying to hit Yambo, looks like it missed. There's a lot of gun rounds coming for us now, we're in big trouble. Yambo dodging all sorts of craziness here. Vickers are coming in from Eons, trying to save Yambo. Looks like the shot's on Missy, and it gets him. Oh, I'm sorry, Missy, brother, but that was a great shot from, I think it was Eons Wizard out now on Kayakawa, who won't see the shot coming because he's too busy shooting with guns. And it missed. It looks like it just missed. Here's another one coming from Wizard. That one missed as well. Missed! Oh, dude, that's a maneuver kill. I was just about to say, Kaya Kiowa doing such a good job at bobbing and weaving and staying alive. Holy shit. That's Octable Fire taking down somebody off the nose. This guy doesn't have a name. Oh, shit. Yeah, it was Octable Fire. Octable out wheeling and dealing again, defending Galetsnik at the death here. Novo, sorry. Jesus Christ, guys! I might need to take a quick coffee break. Red are all over Novo. We need the power of Tel'Jah and Octable Fire here. You guys are our only hope. Help us, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're our only hope here. The Reds are all over the place. Eon's looking to run down people in lead pursuit. We got the two Stalin buses of Fortunato and Aggressor, possibly on another rocket run. The door gunners are engaging the blue infantry. Don't crash, dude. They're dropping troops. Look at those fucking guys! Amazing! Oh, I fucked it! Oh, Fortunato, bro! Oh no, that was Octopole! Octopole shot him! So, Fortunato did get his troops out, so he's a fucking legend for that, but Octopole Fire took him out just in the nick of time. Octopole Fire just wheeling and dealing. Now he's going to have to try and run this. Or Tel'Jah's going to run him down. I think Octable actually crashed. Yeah, he's. Oh, look at the infantry are shooting him. Look at that. So Octable Fire's day goes from bad to worse. The enemy infantry. Oh my god, that is fucking amazing. That's the first. I've never seen that before. That is awesome. Oh, shout out to ALPENWOLF. You really have done it this time, buddy. This is awesome, Alpen. You've nailed it, dude. You fucking nailed it. This is awesome. So Tel'Jah needs to get over here with a gun and start engaging these enemy infantry. They're going to run out of ammo because they just keep shooting at Octopole. This is what you get, Octopole. You brought this on yourself, dude. This is karma. This is karma. Oh, for all the fucking. For all the fathers and sons that you've taken. This is karma coming back for you, Octopole. You made your bed, bro. You can lie in it. Alright, looks like the moving guys around. Oh, look at that. They're fucking controlling the guys to go and attack the blue infantry. Oh my god, this is fucking amazing. We got fucking ground warfare here, guys. Look, we're Oscar Mike. Not sure how we're... Ah, Wags. What the fuck? Come on, son! Oh, I know what this needs. It would have been better if it was going backwards, but you can't win them all. Someone's killing us! Oh, it's Bullet! Run, bro, run, get in the house! Oh my god! Ah, Bullet shot! Oh, I'm on the roof! Great shooting by Bullet. Took them down. Door gunners wrecked them. Nice job, guys. Nice job. Bullet off loads of troops. Good job, sir. Good job. Oh shit, we're getting shot! Enemy spotted. Oh my god, that K50 is just raining the pain down. Look at this, guys. This is awesome. Oh, he's giving up the ghost now. I think Bullet's still alive, though. So who is that? That is Wizard coming down with a pain. So that's probably Eons. He's right on top. Holy shit, guys. Shit is getting really real. We've got a lot of rounds coming in from the back here. We're in trouble. This is Eons getting engaged by Bullet. Oh, he's taking a nice little snapshot off the nose on... that was Switch. We hit Switch. Nice job, dude. Still got Bullet in the back. Looking for some vengeance. Bullet trying to run down this K50. Oh, well, there it goes. There it is. Nice job, Bullet. Nice job, dude. Nice job. Oh, I said we may have got a team kill. Bullet team killed Switch. I'm not sure how that happened. But Wizard is still alive, but Wizard's actually dead. Wizard is definitely dead. Damn, this is getting intense, guys. Right, some long-range Vickers coming in. Looks like these guys, Mustang, very sensibly, just deciding to wait on the other side. And he's saying, hey, I've got a fucking camera and all this shit in this aircraft. I don't need to be bloody merged with people. Fire it. Oh, here we go. Mistral out. Boom! In the face! In the face, son! This is Mustang getting Vickers out on that Gazelle that just shot the bro in the face. Looks like they're both tracking. The Gazelle's fired another Mistral. And another one bites the dust for Mustang. God damn it, Musters. I'm sure this guy... This guy, by the way, this guy is just this guy. How many kills has he got? Like 19? He's 6-0. Holy shit. So yeah, Mustang kind of getting the memo that, hey, we've got a long-range camera and I got long-range rockets. I'm just going to sit on this side of the bay and just start killing people. Mustang probably already sees this other aircraft in front of him here. Let's have a look, see if we can see him. Oh yeah, we can. Sorry, guys. Where is it? There it is. So Mustang can definitely will be able to see this guy already. So he's just tracking him in his camera just now, waiting for a good weapon solution. I'm expecting a Fox from Old Musters anytime now. Good old Musters. Oh. Right, we're targeting this cave. They're targeting this helicopter. Looks like a Huey. Oh, and he fucking hit a Mustang. You are unbelievable. This is... God damn it, I feel terrible. What a way to represent the squadron, though, dude. Oh my god. 7-0. Alright, we got Wyan coming back with Requiem. Prophet looks like he maybe sees... Mustang, but Mustang looks like he's cold. Oh, no, we're going to be turning back in by the looks of things. He's maybe getting a call on the radio. Mustang, there's a Gazelle approaching you. He is low off the nose, approximately 1 mile. And you're left 11 o'clock. I don't think Mustang sees him. This might be a great opportunity for Prophet to put down the mighty Musters. Holy shit, Prophet sees him. Prophet must see him. Look at this. Mustang doesn't see him though. This could be karma. This could be karma coming for Mustang, guys. We've seen it happen to Octopole. Although karma might even save him. I don't think fucking Prophet sees him. Come on, Prophet. Surely you see him. Yes. Oh, karma's coming for Mustang. Sorry, bro, but you can't win them all. It's been a great show, dude. It's been a great show. We've enjoyed watching it, Musters. What a way to represent, champ. I'm afraid it's over. Oh, dude, what the fuck? No! Don't let this happen, man! Come on! Yeah, there it is. Oh, Mustang. I'm sorry, dude. I'm sorry, but you were having too much fun, bro. You were having too much fun, Mustang. He's just going to fly away. Oh, you couldn't fucking write. You couldn't make this shit up. You could not make this shit up. Holy fuck. Now we're targeted on someone else. Uh-oh. Oh no, K50, don't do that! Oh, that was close, dude. He almost went straight into the ground. This gazelle's gonna buy it. Yep, maneuver kill. Maneuver kill. That's a maneuver kill for Hell Requiem. Good job, dude. Ah, it says it got him with a gun, so he must have been a little bit damaged, but good God, man. Mustang, still just, Jesus. Oh, it doesn't sound very healthy. Right, guys, I need to make a coffee, all right? You can judge me all you want. There's nothing you guys can do to stop me, all right? I am going to make a quick coffee, okay? I'm going to have a borderline anxiety attack here, guys. Holy shit. So I'm going to leave it on the screen. I'll be as fast as I can. I'll be right back. Oh, kettle's boiling. Ah, oh, unlucky lazy. Just too exposed, man. I just quickly while the kettle's boiling, guys, run back. Too exposed. Red side need to stop running across this strait of water here. This is a bad idea. This is just suicide. All right. Use your cameras, guys. Do what Mustang was doing. Settle up where Requiem is now. Start launching weapons into the AO. There's no need for the red side to start crossing this stretch of water here. I like what Ross, Baron, Ollie, and Ruben are doing. They're trying to flank around the side. Very sensible decision. I like to see some good sound tactical decision making. We got Mustang still, man. This guy would fall off a boat and not get wet. What a show, though. What a show by Mustang. And Octopal Fire as well. So the two sort of usual suspects. Shout out to Wizard. Wizard's had some great kills. Eons had a great kill with the Vicar as well that we'd seen. The OR guys doing a great job. Missy from the Fighting 99th doing a great job as well. Obviously Tiger wheeling and dealing out there. So yeah, everybody doing a great job, guys. Really well done. Well done, everybody. So now that it is in a little bit of a lull, I can hear the kettle's just about to be finished, guys. So I'm going to quickly go and finish making this coffee and I'll be right back. Hopefully we're not going to miss too much action here. What I'll do is I'll just put it... I'll put us here. I'll bring it back. Right, where are we? Shots fired, negative, we're okay. So we didn't really miss anything, guys. We got Grumpy and Bullet, looks like they're reinforcing. We got Missy coming down reinforcing as well. They're just touching now. Getting the troops on the ground. Good old Missy, love this guy. He's probably streaming right now, guys, on Twitch. Make sure you check him out, he's a great streamer. So he's on the ground, he's landed, he's deploying his troops. I want to keep an eye on this, although it looks like Baron's left this little Stalin package. I think he was supposed to be the escort. He's going to end up getting wrecked. Oh, Pitbull. Pitbull's right there, dude. Right there, fam! Yeah, he definitely sees us. Look, we can see the two pilots. This guy is in big trouble. Baron, I'm sorry, sir. But mistakes were made. Dun-dun. Surprise, motherfucker. Oh, and he didn't make it count. Great flying, though. Great flying by Pitbull there to get around back again. Oh, bro! Oh, what a shot. What a shot. Good job, Pitbull. That was awesome. That was awesome, dude. All right, yeah, now the Stalin buses are in deep shit. The escort got segregated and fucking wrecked. Sorry, I'm just thinking there, guys. My stream is not suitable for workers or children. I apologize. I know I swear all the time, guys, and maybe it would be better if I didn't swear, but I'm Scottish and I'm excited, so I apologize for the amount of times that I swear. Don't necessarily apologize for swearing itself, though, so. Anyway, back to it. We got these Stalin buses. It looks like they're going to get ran down. This is not looking good, guys. Look, here comes Death. Death is coming, guys. Octable fire's out there somewhere. We're all in trouble, bro. We're all in trouble. Just land and run away, guys. Octable fire's coming. Oh, this is going to be a massacre. This is going to be a fucking massacre. Alright, one of them's hit already. This is Octable, I can tell. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, God. Oh, no, guys, I'm so sorry. Just no mercy. No mercy. I feel a little sad. That's took the wind out of my sails a little bit. Get out of here, Stalin, you buster. Looks like we're going to have Bullet head-to-head with Fortinero any second now. This is going to be good, guys. Bullet with a bit in his teeth, ready to put some bullets in. Bullet's ready to put some bullets in people. All right, we'll stick with Team Freedom. All right, Bullet is targeted. 100% sees him. Let's go, bro. What we got? Shots fired, goddammit. Damn. Oh, we got hits. Merged! Oh, Fortinero doing a great job in the turn there. That was beautiful. That was fucking beautiful. Good job, sir. Oh god, he might even win this. Come on, Stalin. Shoot, Joseph, shoot! Ah, oh, you fucked it. No, 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 no. Oh, son. I'm not giving him too much shit, guys. These helicopters are actually really hard to fly. And he was probably, he probably had engine damage from when Bullet hit him. Oh shit, he's getting ran down by another one. Here comes the second Soviet bus in the back. Come on, bro. That's Vidania. We got shots landing everywhere. Davai, davai! Skimmy nimmy naziv! Oh, don't do that. Oh, shit, son! That escalated quickly! What the fuck? Who was that? Tiger to the rescue! The guy has the eye of the tiger. Came to the rescue and saved his his squadron mate. 104 cadet Bullet. God damn it, son. That was good. Mustang's back on his feet. He's just a man with the will to survive. Don't worry, Red Side. Mustang's coming. Fourth Tiger, ladies and gentlemen. That's enough of that. Alright, we've got Wizard in a reasonably exposed position. Doesn't look like he sees any of the guys close to him either. We have Prophet, Missy, and Telja pretty much right off the nose here. They're not actually that far at all. They are 2 miles off the nose, so definitely within visual range. Don't think we're sorted on them yet, though. We've got Mustang coming, so that, yeah, we'll stick with Mustang. Something's definitely going to happen. Mustang needs to slow his roll a little bit. I don't think he knows that the blues. Yeah, he's just going to start slowing down now. There's the blues off the left. Wrong button, sorry, guys. Mustang needs to be careful here. He's got 3 blue aircraft passing on his left. These guys are well within 1 mile now. We're going to start seeing some shots coming out from good old Musters. Oh, one of them's down. One of them's down. That might be... Oh, Eon's got him. So Mustang definitely sees the splashes and stuff now. There's some more helicopters off to his right-hand side. It looks like we're targeting a guy on the left, though. Yeah, he's going for the guy on the left. He needs to forget about this guy. He needs to focus on this guy now. Because he has another aircraft over there. He's shooting at the guy on the left. Did we get him? Oh, Oh, karma might be coming from again. Oh, he doesn't see him. This guy doesn't see him. Oh shit, is that a, no, that's a bus. So Mustang got another kill there. He did get that guy. So we're now 8-0. One of his kills didn't count that he got there. So Mustang is now 8-0. What a way to represent, sir. Thank you very much. Doing the squadron proud. Quick little shout out, guys, to the 100 Kiap squadron, who are a Russian Su-33 squadron. They are actually recruiting right now, guys. So if any of you guys are interested in joining like a sort of Russian unit that specifically focuses on flying from aircraft carriers, have a look at 100 Kiap squadron, K-I-A-P, 100 K-I-A-P. They're recruiting right now on ED forums. Here comes two foxes out from good old Musters on the cold Mustang, Gazelle. It's going to hit that tree. No, it's not. Oh, and he gets them as well. Jesus Christ, Mustang. 9-0. Fucking guys, 9-0. Right, we got Bullet out there wheeling and dealing. Some brave shots. Oh, no, Aggressor's going to buy it here. This Mistral is inbound. Oh, it missed. This is Tiger shooting again. Aye, the Tiger. Flare out, though. Flare out. And it missed. It missed again. So Aggressor is still okay, managed to defend. Bullet's trying to run him down. These guys need to be careful. They're going to end up getting themselves flanked right up here. Eons and Pitbull are going to end up going head to head here. They don't see each other though. Oh, shoot at somebody else. Interesting, very interesting. Eons doesn't see him. Here comes another Mistral on Wizard this time. It looks like it might have hit him. It did hit him. His tail rotor's damaged, but he's still in there. Got all his lights on, which is not ideal. He's kind of getting the program now and getting some flares out. Kind of fix. Oh, here we go. Octopal fire on Mustang. This would be the challenge of the Titans. Who is he targeted on? Oh no, he's targeted on Wizard right now. He's just fired on Wizard. Oh, good kill, dude. Good kill. That's some more good kills from Octopal. No mercy. No mercy. He's going down, though. Oh, shit, son. Oh, he's okay. He is okay. That was Octopal on Lazy Seal. Looks like he's got... oh, Christ. This is just shooting fish in a barrel. Oh, bro. So there goes Eons. Sorry, that was Wizard. So, yeah, we got Iskrim and Mustang very sensibly getting out of there. Got an enemy Octopal on the fold there. Right, how long have we got left? 20 minutes. Right, I need to sip some coffee, guys. There's nothing you can do to stop me. Hold on. Right, so Octopal looks like he maybe sort of wants to loiter around this area. He's going to try and use this terrain here, I think, and then pop over. It looks like that's what Bullet's exactly trying to do. He's just trying to wait in an ambush position. Love this, Bullet. Some fucking good tactical thinking by my man there. Love this guy. We got Ross Pups heading out with Cag Rubin, Ross Ollie, I don't know what the noise was, sorry guys. We got Baron coming in as well with ECV56 coming back in again, the buses. These guys have been awesome. They've been doing some really cool rocket runs on the enemy airbase and stuff like that. So you got to be in it to win it, and these guys are trying to get a little bit of a hustle on. So Octopal might have Mustang in an ambush position right off the beams here. This is going to be interesting, guys. Oh my god! Oh no! Octopal seen him, and it fucking maneuvered straight away. Does Mustang see him though? Surely Mustang sees him. I think Octopal Fire came over this ridge line and seen like there's like 3 or 4 K50s all waiting for him in an ambush here. I think he fought better of it. Yeah, he's fought better. He's 100%. He's like, no, fuck that. I'm not going in there. So he's trying to reset, maybe try and use this terrain as cover. Turning back in now. Look at he probably sees a high guy. Problem is, as soon as Octopal starts shooting at this high guy, Mustang's going to see him. This is Iskrim, he's in big trouble. He's in big, big trouble. I don't think the fighter controller... Yeah, the fighter controller does see him. Look at Iskrim, maybe trying to pull onto him. Oh, he's fucked. He is. This guy is just a dead man flying. Oh, maybe not, maybe not. Octopal Fire maybe left it a little bit too late and the guy got the call. Fighter controller screaming at Iskrim. Bro, you're merged. Oh, we've got shots coming in on Octopal from the back. It looks like that's Ruben, Cag Ruben, trying to get shots on Octopal from a bus. And Octopal kills the K50. He's going to end up, I'm calling it now, Octopal's going to kill this bus. Oh, Cag Ruben, we had an absolutely beautiful maneuver to get on the 6AM. Oh, that was awesome. Maybe a little bit too early with the guns though. Oh, and he's hit! Octopal is hit! Who got him? I think Mustang might have got him! Who just flew over him? Oh no, it might have been Baron. Baron coming in to save the day there. Good job, Redside. Good job. Oh shit. Bullets in the thick of it. This guy's wheeling and dealing. Bullet's gonna bring the pain right now. Go, bro. Shoot now! Now! Nice, nice. Maybe left it a little bit too late. Oh, the Stalin bus door gunner's getting some action on the bullet. Trying to get the nose round here. Let's go, bro. Open it up. Bus is still going though. Watch those trees, brother. Oh, he got rescued. Someone came in and took him out. Who was that? That was Fortinero. So another bus came in and saved him. Great teamwork, Redside. Oh my god. Some absolutely fantastic teamwork. That was his wingman as well. Look, ECV56 was the guy that was being attacked by Bullet. ECV56 Fortinero was the guy that came in and saved him. Hashtag teamwork makes the dream work, guys. How long we got left? 13 minutes, something like that. I'm gonna give them a bit. Yeah, I'll give them an extra, a little while. This has been great fun, guys. This has been an absolutely epic event. Mustang sitting pretty on 9-0. Tiger's got 6 kills. Nice job, dude. Dope man 6-0 as well. Nice, man. Some strong showings from some of the pilots here. Good job, guys. Good job. Great job. Aggressors in trouble, here they come. Bang, bang. Did they miss? Nope. We are going down, ladies and gentlemen. Bump. Bloop. That was another kill from Tiger. Tiger on 7 kills now. Nice. If you're enjoying the show, if you're watching and you're enjoying the show, guys, and you think, hey, I'd like to do this, we run these events in the 104 in conjunction with our friend ALPENWOLF, who is the guy that runs the Cold War server. He designs the missions and we host it in conjunction with him. The sign-up is always open, guys, to anyone that has a helicopter in DCS. You are more than welcome to come and join us, okay? The sign-up is on ED Forums. You need to have an account, a forum account on ED Forums. And you need to go to the tournament section on ED Forums and look for the sign-up. The sign-ups are labelled as Helicopter PvP Tournament. Like I said, you're more than welcome to join us, guys. We try and do this once every, 2 months. Once every, every other month we try and do this. This is the fourth round that we've done so far. Tiger's going to get some great kills here. Look at this. Fox 2, motherfucker. Oh, look, there's a second one, Tiger. Make it count, bro. Get a second one as well. Oh, he's done it, dude. Nice. Oh, beautiful, bro. Fucking beautiful. Eon's ejects. Eon punches out. That's a kill for Tiger. Is the second K50 going to go down, or is he going to be able to auto-rotate that? It looks like he's in trouble. He might get away with that. He might get back. Oh, the guy that Bullet was shooting at actually crashed, so Bullet got credited with that kill. ECV56, is it Trurio or something? I don't know how you pronounce that. I apologise. Yeah, he actually crashed, so Bullet got credited with that kill. So we're getting into the end game now, guys. We've only got about 10 minutes left. Just let everybody know.
Channel edited.
Right, we've got Y, and looks like he's facing up on Switch and Kayakawa. Let's see him. Nobody sees nobody. I think Switch. Yeah, Switch is target. Switch, you're firing way too early, bro. Great maneuver by Wyan to try and get the nose round on one of them. It looks like one of them's getting some hits anyway. Oh, nice! We got a kill! Was that us? I was reading the chat. Yeah, I think it was. Yeah, it was Wyan! So what a way to turn the tables, dude! Holy shit! Love this guy. Oh, this boss is all over him. That is all she wrote, guys. Unfortunately, that didn't go so well. Yeah, a quick tip for you guys. If you're closing in on an enemy that doesn't see you, get closer before you start shooting. Oh, this guy is just not high enough. Look, if he was just a little bit higher, he could see all the enemy aircraft down there. But look, he's just not high enough. Come on, bro, get up a little bit. Look, there's an aircraft there. Oh, this guy could get quite a few kills. I think the reds know where he is as well. I think the red fighter controller can see him. Oh, we're gonna get shot now. Fox 2, come on, bro. Shoot. Come on, dude. Surely you fucking see that guy. Shoot him! What? Why are we not firing? God damn you. Look at all these aircraft. This guy here's got 4 missiles on board. He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 aircraft all within 1 mile. Unfortunately, he doesn't see any of them. He's just, unfortunately, he's just kind of in the wrong place at the wrong time. He's just, if he was 50 feet higher, he would be able to see all those aircraft, but unfortunately he's not. What the fuck? Well, What? Are you fucking shitting me? These fucking guys are running towards the objective on the fucking surface of the sea. That's fucking crazy. Oh, Varus might be going to end up head-to-head with Mustang. Now, this is actually really dangerous for both pilots because this guy's got really good Fox 2, like, heat-seeking missiles on board. So as soon as he gets a tone, he can fire, but... So Mustang's at a bit of a disadvantage like that, but if Mustang sees this guy and he doesn't see Mustang, he's basically dead. It looks like both of them are now starting to fly away from each other as well now, so we're not going to get this merge here. So we're getting into the very last, we've got about 5 or 6 minutes of the event flight, like sort of event time left, and then everybody's got to RTB, so we're kind of, oh shit, I'm trying to drink coffee, I'm selfishly trying to drink coffee guys, sorry. Boom, there he goes. Sorry Wyan, you guys flew over the water when you weren't supposed to fly over the water. That was Dope Man again, I think. So a great showing by Dope Man today. He's had a great little showing. So down he goes. Another one bites the dust, guys. Down Wyan goes. These guys need to stop running across this middle, but maybe like get to here and then just do a quick. Oh, now Fortinero's going to buy it as well. Oh, I missed. Flare out just in time. So Dope is just waiting for him to stop flaring. Here comes a shot. Oh, and it connects. It looks like he's still okay though. Oh my god! Vengeance! Fucking vengeance! Look at that, bro. That was karma. Oh my god. That was awesome. That was... Oh, we're still flying. What a shot. What a shot, dude. Who was that? Who was that guy? Fortinero. Jesus, we love this guy. ECV56 Fortinero, what a shot, dude. What an absolute shot. Needed to save his life. Saved his own life. Oh, now he's getting hit by another guy. There's an L behind him now. Oh, he's shooting at the wrong guy, bro. Oh, lucky. But he goes down a hero. He dies a hero. This gazelle is still flying, though. Look. Right at the death. We got about 4 minutes left. We have Pups, Baron, and Ollie coming up. Mustang, maybe, I think Mustang's been given the call about this guy from the fighter controller, and he's trying to identify him. They're not separated by that much, just like 3 miles, so. It doesn't look like he's got his, Varus needs to get in there, dude. Come on, if you just flew forward, you would kill so many people, man. This guy's going to just miss his opportunity. There's like 4 minutes left and he's just too low. Unfortunately, he is just too low. Tiger coming in with some good shots on Baron. Fox out. Not sure who that's tracking. Nice. Gets a kill at the death. Good kill, Tiger. He probably sees a K50 off the nose. We might not have ammo left. Oh no, he's fired at someone. Who are we shooting at? Oh shit, there's another one there. Oh, it's not tracking though. Well, it looks like he's out of ammo. Ah, poor Varus. Oh, it's too little, too late, bro. Nice! Good job, sir. Well done. Let's find the other ones. Come on, bro. Let's find the other ones. That's a good kill on Baron. Good job, good job. Oh, aggressors coming for him in a bus. They're not going to see each other. Oh, aggressor definitely getting a call. Careful with your main rotor, dude. I'm not sure what's going on there. Oh, Varus is going to end up getting behind him. He should have kept on going and looped round. Mustang maybe sees. Mustang does see him. He's got Mustang as Vickers out. Oh no! Mustang's going to team kill that guy. Oh, Mustang, you're shooting. Oh, Mustang! Mustang, no! Oh, he's still alive though, he's not killed him, so he's only hit him, he's only, I think Mustang's just a friendly tap. What's a friendly missile between friends? Oh no, the game says he's dead. Oh no, no, he's still there, aggressor's okay. It's Varus and Mustang. Are really our only hope. Look at these fucking guys, watch this. How freaky is this? Watch this. Where are they? Fucking, what is this? Pirates in the fucking Caribbean, are you shitting me, bro? What the fuck? Somebody get me Jack Sparrow on the phone. Alright, looks like it's going to go down to the wire with our man Varus. The bus, does the bus see him? Come on, Mr. Bus, do you see us? I don't think he's, oh shit, son, oh shit! Ah, dude, are you fucking kidding? Oh well. Alright guys, that's going to do it, hold on. Jesus, guys, what an event. What an event. That was the best one yet. That was the best one yet. Channel switch. RTB, guys, it's over. Turn around and go back to base.
Copy.
Channel switched.
Yeah, hands down, this was the best one yet. Shout out to, massive shout out to ALPENWOLF, the server admin, host, magician of the Cold War server, guys. He's the one that comes up and puts up, he designs these missions and sets it all up. He's done an absolutely great job. Yeah, this was a good one. This was a great round, guys. Mustang ended up with 10 kills, because one of them didn't, he didn't get credit for at least one of them. So, Mustang went at least 10-0. What a champ. We're going to have a quick like debrief. We always do a debrief at the end, guys. So I'm going to wrap it up. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks. Sorry if I didn't answer any of your questions or give any of the people that followed the channel a shout out. I hugely appreciate your guys' support. Sorry, I just couldn't keep track of what was going on in the event and answer questions and all that stuff as well. I hope you enjoyed it. I really enjoyed being here. Again, if you want to take part, guys, you are more than welcome to join us. You have to have an account on ED Forums, and then you sign up in the tournament section, okay? And then you can. We're probably going to have the next one in March, but keep your eyes posted for that, and hopefully we'll catch you guys in the 104 server or just generally kicking around a bit of community. Thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you in the next one. Top Gun and Volleyball. Peace.